Hello, I'm very glad you decided to join us today. Today we are going to be reading a very exciting story. Let's begin. The story of faithful Khadija. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam belonged to the tribe of the Quraysh. He was an orphan. His father died before he was born. His mother died when he was a young child. He began to live with his grandfather, Abdul Muttalib. And after the death of his grandfather, his uncle, Abu Talib, became his guardian. But Allah looked after him. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was a very honest man. The people of Mecca called him Al-Amin, which means trustworthy one. He worked with the Quraysh traders, traveling with their caravans across the desert. Now, Khadija at that time was ranked highest among the Quraysh. She was very dignified and also very rich. She was a widow and looked after her business herself. She heard that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was a very honest person. She said to him, "Take my goods to Syria and trade them there. Buy other goods with the money you get and bring them to Mecca." Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam took the goods to Syria, sold them there, and with the money he got, he bought other goods for Khadija. When Khadija sold these goods in Mecca, she made lots of profit. She liked Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam's honesty, and she married him. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Khadija had two sons, Qasim and Abdullah. But both of them died when they were very small. They also had four daughters, Zainab, Ruqayya, Umm Kulthum, and Fatima. All these daughters lived to see their father become the messenger of Allah. One day, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to the cave of Hira. Suddenly, Jibreel appeared before him. He taught the Prophet verses from the Quran. He said, "Muhammad, you are the messenger of Allah." The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam got frightened. He could not believe that Allah sent an angel to him. He could not believe that Allah chose him as a messenger. He went home and told Khadija, "Something strange has happened to me. An angel of Allah called Jibreel came and spoke to me. I cannot believe that Allah sent Jibreel to speak to me. I cannot believe that Allah wants me to be his messenger." But Khadija had no doubts. "You're honest and you're trustworthy. Allah knows that you're honest and trustworthy. Surely Allah made you a prophet to your people. I believe in Allah, and I believe in the revelation he gave you." Khadija was the very first person to hear what had happened in the cave of Hira. She was also the very first person to accept Islam. She was the greatest support to the Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as she lived. Allah honored her with many great virtues, and she was Allah's faithful servant. Well, that's it for our story today. Come back tomorrow for the first converts. I hope you liked our story. Don't forget to tune in tomorrow so you can hear some more. Oh, and if you don't want to miss it, why not go down, like, subscribe, and if you like, comment to let us know what you think.